Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. Now you're working with Power BI Report Server and you got lots of paginated reports there, but you want to move them up to the service because you want to centralize everything in one thing. But you're like, how do I migrate? I don't have premium. What do I do? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you. Stay tuned. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and Patrick. Power BI Report Server, great product. It's been out for a while. If you use SSRS, it's just a superset of SSRS with a lot of great features for hosting Power BI reports. But now you're like, man, I'm using the Power BI Report Server and I want to take all my paginated reports and move them to the Power BI service, but I don't have premium. Patrick, you did a video on that RDO migration tool. Can Microsoft just make it easier? Well, they just did. If you download and install the latest version of Power BI Report Server, you're gonna see a really cool feature that's out there. So enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Before you start this migration, definitely go give this a look. I think I talked about this document in the initial video with the RDO migration tool. It talks about the unsupported data sources, unsupported features. They give you like the steps you need to discover what's out there, assess your environment, and then prepare for the upgrade. And then it gives you these post-migration steps, setting query timeouts and configuring your data sources and things like that. Go take a look at this. The next thing you need to do is head out to Power BI and create you a workspace. Or if you already have one created where you want to deploy those docs, you can use that. But you can see I created me a workspace to hold my migrated paginated reports. You don't need to do this. You can do whatever you want. But what's amazing about this workspace? It's not premium. You no longer need premium or premium per user to host paginated reports in Power BI. What? I love it. So once you have your workspace set up, head over to your Power BI report server. And you can see I've moved all my reports to a given folder, the ones I want to migrate. And now, before I do the actual migration, let me show you something. This particular report right here, I go to manage. This report, I just entered some data. Notice in the data source, it just says enter data. For both of these reports, for the invoice and the labels, I enter data. For this particular report, let's take a look. Let's go to manage. And so you can see this one is using an embedded data source and data set. And then this one, I just want to show you the different types of connections and data sources I'm using here. So let's go to manage. And for this one, I'm just using the shared data set that I created out there. If you want more information on how do I create the shared data set, how do I connect to a shared data set, how am I using a shared data source, let me know. Post it in the comments below and maybe we'll do some videos on it. And then the final report, manage, it is using the shared data source. So I got a good mix of features and capabilities here. So now you know everything about my reports. The way that you get them to the service, you just publish them. You can do them one at a time. So you can click on the ellipsis here and choose publish to Power BI. Or you can go up here, see where it says publish, and you click the drop down. You can choose to publish all the reports or select individual reports. You know, maybe you only want to publish a couple. So I'm going to choose select reports. And what you see here is I can choose the ones I want, or I just can check this box and say migrate them all. Let's migrate them all. So I'm going to choose publish to Power BI. I'm going to prompt to sign in. I've already authenticated. And I would say, hey, where do you want to put this? I want to put this in that migrated paginated folder. This is just general use right now. You can choose the sensitivity label that you want to specify. I'm going to go ahead and choose publish. And it says, hey, this is going to take a few minutes. Give it a few minutes. Four out of the five were published. And then it's saying, hey, Patrick, this one right here with the drill through feature is not supported. Remember when I said read the doc and find out which features are not supported? Obviously, I didn't do a good job, right? Drill through is not supported. And before we fix it, take a look here. So if I come here and I refresh, you'll see all of my reports have been migrated. I can click one, take a little bit to get it, but there you go. And so if I go back to my workspace, if I go here, and I go to manage, this is where I can go and configure my data source, but I've already configured the data sources for my report. So I'm going through an on-premises gateway because I'm accessing this data on-prem. But what about the other report? So the other report, it couldn't migrate. It was very explicit about it. Sales and monthly rank by year. So let's go back over to Power BI report server and let's go make some changes to this report. So all you need to do is click the ellipsis and say edit in report builder. So once the report opens, it's pretty clear that something's going on with this column. So if I right click on it, go to text box properties, choose action, and then you'll see that I have go to report, which enables the drill through. And so that's not supported in paginated reports today, but there's a quick workaround that you can do. You can change that to go to URL. And then if you hit over to Power BI, and I remember which report I was drilling through to, it's this report details. If I open this report, and all I really need is this URL. So I'm gonna grab this URL, and you can use URL parameters. So let me show you what I'm talking about. But you can paste these URL parameters in. And so if I copy this and go over, just open up a new tab, what you're gonna see if I run this, it's gonna apply these values, 2011 and number of year one, to my parameters. And so it's running, and you can see it's only returned in January. If I just change this really quick to two, it is gonna change the value in the parameter for month of years two. And then you can see everything is February. So now I just need to make that dynamic. So what I'm gonna do is, let me get this, the URL for the report back on my clipboard. I already wrote this out so you wouldn't have to watch me. And what I did was I took the URL to that report published to Power BI, put a question mark, RP is report parameter, the name of the parameter equals. And so I'm building a string. So you can see I wrapped the entire URL in the string, and I'm using ampersand to concatenate, and I'm getting the value from that field for calendar and month number. So we do this, take that, and we go back to the report builder and go to expression. And let's just go ahead and paste this in, click OK, click OK. And then let's save this, and it's saving it back up to the report server, because you can see I'm connected to that report server. Let's run it before we actually try the migration and do a little test. And then I'm gonna expand out 2013. You can see my hyperlink, and I'm gonna click this. Let's open this in Edge. As you can see, 2013, month of year four, and you'll see my parameters, 2013, month of year four, and it's only returned in April 2013. So now if I go back to my report server, choose this one and say, publish this to Power BI, cross my fingers, cross my toes, put this in my Migrate paginated reports, click publish, may take a few minutes, voila, it's published. Let's head over to Power BI in that workspace. There it goes. Let's click this one, load in my report. There's my rows. Let's choose 2014 and click May. And just like that, 2014 May, and it's taking me to that paginated report. I can create a back button on this report. But just like that, I migrated some reports. I got an error. Hey, you're using drill through. I fixed it, and then I migrated the corrected report, and now everything works. All right, what do you think? Are you ready to migrate from Power BI report server to the Power BI service? Go kick the tires on it. Let me know what you think. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. You like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.